Good morning, friends. We continue our lecture on coordinate geometry. We have done the distance formula, right? D is equal to under root x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. But the sums we have done so far were related to numbers. Now we have got variables here. We have got the points a plus b, a minus b, and a minus b comma minus a minus b. So this point doesn't have numbers. You can call this point AB or PQ or whatever, XY. But now there are no numbers here, right? There are variables. So we should be able to extend our distance formula to variables also. So this is for the practice. So what will the distance be between these two points? Now I want you to be careful about writing here. Let us call the points PQ. And the distance PQ, what care will you take here? You will write x2 minus x1. So keep them in bracket. Okay? So we have got x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1. Now what is y2? Minus a minus b minus a minus b the whole into bracket, the whole square. So this, see this step carefully how I have written. The whole point with the minus sign, yes, so we have got x2 in bracket minus x1 in bracket, y2 in bracket minus y1 in bracket. Now you will see why this step is very, very important. When you open the bracket, we have got a minus b here, but because of this negative sign, the signs inside will change. A is positive, becomes negative, B is positive, becomes negative. So the signs have changed here, right? Then we have the same way here, minus A minus B, initial signs don't change, but here the signs must change. So minus A and minus becomes plus B. So you can see again, we have used the distance formula. The same thing we have written x2 minus x1, but the x2 is in the form a minus b. The y2 is in the form minus a minus b. So you have to be only careful with the signs. And if you are careful with the signs, you will get your answer easily. So this now becomes a and minus a gets cut. So minus b is minus 2b the whole square. Plus here minus b and plus b gets cut. So we've got minus a, minus 2a the whole square. So how much is this? Negative. Minus 2 into minus 2 is 4. So 4b square plus 4a square. We take out the 4 common. So a square plus b square. And the 4 has got the under root 2. So 2 comes outside and inside the bracket a square plus b square. So this is the distance formula we used. What I wanted to see here is, what I want you to see here is what? That we have not used numbers. Instead, we have used variables. Okay, so as an MCQ, this sum can be asked. So we have worked with numbers. Today we are going to work with variables. So this was the first. Now we'll move on to the second. Okay? The second looks slightly tricky, but still we'll have to find the easier method to solve it. Okay, what we have got now, let us call this point RS. So, RS is equal to under root, what have you got here? 82 square minus 81 square the whole square. So, you see this square the whole square. Because this point is 82 the whole square minus 81 the whole square plus, what have we got here? 282 minus 281 the whole square. Now you can see this is only the formula which is used, but now we have to think a method which will make it simpler. So what is common here? A is common in both here, right? So first I will take the A common. So I make a square bracket here because the square root is outside. From this I take the A common. What happens in the bracket? T2 square minus T1 square the whole square. Sorry, not the whole square, outside the square bracket, the whole square. And what I can take common here, 2a can come out common. So t2 minus t1 the whole square. So this is the step you have to be careful with. How to make the sum easier. Now we have got this a square. So I take it outside the bracket. And how can I write t2 square minus t1 square? This can be written as t2 minus t1 into t2 plus t1. Okay, I'll not continue the bracket here. Let me write it a into t2 minus t1, t2 plus t1. And this is again the whole square. So the a was there. I have only expanded this bracket. A square minus b square is a minus b into a plus b. So I've written this as t2 minus t1, a minus b into a plus b. The whole square still remains. No change. Plus 2a t2 minus t1 the whole square. Yes? What will the next step be? A square, because you know the law of exponents. So we write this as a square t2 minus t1 the whole square. t2 plus t1 the whole square. You know the law of exponents. AB raised to m equal to a raised to m into b raised to m. So we have got a into t2 minus t1 into t2 plus t1. So it becomes a square t2 minus t1 the whole square, t2 plus t1 the whole square. And what have we got here? 2a square. So this becomes 4a square. How 4a square? 2a square. So 2 square is 4a square and t2 minus t1 the whole square. Okay. Now what can we take out common in this two? So what you can take out common is, let us see what comes out common. The a square is common in both. I take it outside. And t2 minus t1 the whole square is also common. So t2 minus t1, sorry, t square of t2. So t2 minus t1 the whole square, I took out common. What remains in the bracket? t2 plus t1 the whole square minus, and here only 4 remains. Only 4 remains. Okay? So if we intend to solve this further, this can be solved further in a different ways, but if we intend to solve it further, what will we write? This is a square and this is a square, and it's a multiplication. So this I can take outside the bracket. So I get a bracket t2 minus t1 outside, and what remains on the inside is this. Okay, but how I can write this on the inside? t2 minus t1 the whole square minus 4 can be written as 2 square. So I can finally write this as t2 minus t1, and under root, what is a square minus b square? It is a minus b into a plus b. So in the MCQ, you might have lot of simplified forms, right? I've written the sum in all the simplified forms. In the MCQ, you might have a lot of simplified forms. Okay, there is a mistake here. I guess the mistake is made. This is plus. So because it is a plus, then this cannot be solved further. So the answer will remain till here only. Yes? You have to be careful with the signs also. I told you. So I made a mistake here. Kindly correct the mistake. We have got this plus sign here, not a minus sign. So if it is a plus sign, then we don't have any formula called a square plus b square. The formula is for a square minus b square. So the answer ends here. This is the final answer. Now what I wanted to see in this sum is, you have to use this distance formula. This is the same distance formula we have been using for so long, but here there are no numbers. There are only variables. So sum can be asked of this form also. It may look difficult to you, but that is not an issue at all. It is not difficult at all. You have to just write the formula. You have to put the numbers according to the variables. So x2 minus x1 the whole square, y2 minus y1 the whole square. But you can see this is a square inside the bracket. So you have to keep on solving it in the most simplest way possible. Now what was the other method you could do? You could open this bracket. A minus B. You want to try it out? Let us try it out and see how it works out. Because you can choose your method. Now what is A minus B the whole square? It is A square. So this becomes, what is the square of this? A square T square raised to 4. Because the square of T square is 2 raised to 4 minus 2AB. So minus 2AB means 2 into this and this. So A into A is A square. And T2 into T1 square is what? T1 square T2 square plus B square. So what do we have? A square T1 raised to 4. Yes, plus open this bracket the same way. So what is the square of this? 4. What do you have? 4 A square T2 square.
A square T2 square
minus 2. Now 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. 8 A square T1 T2 plus 4 A square T1 square. So this is what you get. Yes? And then you have to take out things common and come to this answer. So this looks slightly difficult because you have opened the bracket. Now what do you do after opening the bracket? You have got your A square T square raised to 4. So from here and here you can take A square T square common. From here and here you can take A square T1 square common. So you have to take out common, and this is slightly difficult. So this is the easier method. We just expand the brackets, take out what is common and come to the answer. So these two sums I've done for you. Looks very complex, but you'll have to practice more kinds of sum like this. Okay, now this sum says a point xy is equidistant from this point and this point. We have to prove bx equal to ay. Now what is the meaning of the word equidistant? So let me draw a point. So this point is a plus b comma b minus a. This point. We want another point here which is a minus b a plus b. Okay, the coordinate c are in variables. Now this point xy, so let me call this point P, let me call this point Q. Now this point X, let me call this point X. This point is equidistance means, point is XY. What is the meaning of the word equidistance? The distance from this point and the distance from this point is same, means PX equal to QX. So what is the question telling us here? Is this point is equidistance from both these points. I have written both the points. And this point is an equal distance from both these points, the equidistant. Now it is given to us and we have to prove that bx equal to ay. So you can see this sum. What is given to us? Equidistance means we have to find the distance of these two points. But ultimately we have to prove that bx equal to ay. So to prove this, what we are given? We are given bx equal to qx, right? So using the distance formula, what is px equal to? Px is a plus b minus x, a plus b minus x the whole square plus b minus a minus y the whole square, b minus a minus y the whole square. Now we have not put the brackets inside because this is a single variable. If it would be a double variable like this, I would have to put a bracket, open the bracket and take care of the signs. Okay, and we have qx, a minus b minus x the whole square and a plus b minus y the whole square. So this is what we have got, right? Do you follow this?
I have written the distance formula.
Okay, now you can see there's a square root on both sides. So if I square both the sides, if I direct initially, if I had squared both the sides, what I could do? I could directly remove the square to make the sum easier. So you have to remember, you can only remove square roots if the square root is there on both the sides. If the square root is there on only one side, then to remove the square root from one side, you have to square the other side. But here the square root was on both sides, so we have used this. Now, what will I do here? A plus b minus x the whole square. Here you can use two different formula. Yes? If you know the formula you have done in the 9th standard, a plus b minus c the whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Yes, you know that formula. Or you can break up this into, say, c and d. C minus d the whole square is what? C square minus 2cd. I'll tell you what I mean to say. Let me write down here. One formula I can do is a plus b plus c the whole square equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. This is one formula for this. The second formula I mean to say, a plus b plus c the whole square, I can take the a plus b as one unit. Then this becomes a plus b the whole square plus 2 into a plus b into c plus c square. So you can see, either you break up into units or use this formula directly. So I am going to use the previous formula, this one. Okay, it will expand the sum a little more, but I want to use that formula because it will be a revision for the formula of the 9. So let us begin and write down the whole thing down. What do you get here? So this implies a square plus b square plus x square plus, both are positive. So a into b is 2ab plus, no, now minus. Why? Because a into minus x is minus 2ax and b into minus x is minus 2bx. Plus, same way here, b square plus a square plus y square. Now we got minus, a into b is minus, so minus 2ab, b into y, minus 2by, but minus into minus plus, so plus 2ay. This is what we expanded. Now we expand this one. Again we get a square plus b square plus x square. Now a into b, because minus b, so minus 2ab, minus 2ax, but plus 2bx. And here we get a square plus b square plus y square plus 2ab minus 2ay minus 2by. Okay? What is cut on both sides? A square, b square, x square. On both the sides of equal to b square, a square, y square, b square, a square. A square on both sides. What else is getting cut? We got a minus 2ab here and a minus 2ab here which gets cut. A minus 2ax here and a minus 2x here which gets cut. Yes? Now this will not get cut because this is minus 2 and this is plus 2. On the signs are not equal. What else gets cut? This 2ab and 2ab gets cut. This will not be cut because the signs are different, but this 2 will get cut. So what are we left with? We are left with minus 2bx plus 2ay equal to 2bx minus 2ay. Now the minus 2ay goes on this side, becomes plus 2ay. So 2ay plus 2ay equal to 2bx goes on this side, plus 2bx. Yes, so this is what it implies. So what we get here? 4ay equal to 4bx. The 4s get cut on both sides, then we have bx equal to ay. So have we got the answer? So the answer is quite simple. You can see here, what is there is this expansion. We have used distance formula, but now we have got no numbers here. We are using the distance formula with variables. Same method, same procedure, but very careful with the signs. If you get a sign wrong here, I got in the previous sum, remember, if you get a sign wrong here, the answer can go wrong. So you have to do it very slowly with concentration. As you will practice, you will be faster and accurate, but you have to try to do it without any mistake. If you make a mistake somewhere, it becomes very difficult to find the mistake. So go very slowly and very firmly. Okay, which formula I use? I use a plus b minus c the whole square, that formula. So this is there in the ninth standard. If you have forgotten it, revise it first and then come back to this sum, but practice this. So today we have done which kind of sums? Sums that do not have numbers but have only variables. But as you saw, these sums are using the same pattern. So we have done sums based on which formula? The distance formula. Okay, so this was sums based on distance formula using only variables. This next sum has got variables a minus a minus root 3a and root 3a. Now what is the question? We have to show that these three points form an equilateral triangle and will also find its area. So this is going to have both the formulae. Okay, you know how to find the area? We can use that formula, but now we will not use that. Once we find the equilateral, so first let us prove it is an equilateral triangle. Let me call this point A, let me call this point B, let me call this point C. So what is AB equal to? Another formula, minus A the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1, minus A the whole square. What is this? Minus A, what is that, you know, minus 2A the whole square, minus A, minus 2a the whole square. What do you get? 4a square plus 4a square equal to how much? Under root 8a square. Now how you write 8a square? 4 2s are 8. 4 I bring outside. So 2 root 2. Sorry? Okay? Then a square will come out. So it becomes 2a root 2. Or we can also write it the way it is written in numbers. 2 root 2 number and the variable a. So we have got ab equal to 2 root 2a. Now what will we try? We'll first find bc. Formula. What is the formula? Minus root 3a minus a the whole square plus root 3a. Sorry. Minus root 3a minus a, minus a will become plus a, and this also minus will become plus a the whole square. Now what will you do here? What is minus root 3a the whole square? Is 3a square minus root 3 into 1 into 2, so minus 2 root 3a plus a square. If you understood this step very well, what I have done, I have got minus root 3. So what is a plus b the whole square? A square. So what is minus root 3a the whole square? Minus root 3 into minus root 3 is root 9. Root 9 is 3 and a square. This is how I got this a square. So remember this step very well, right? Plus this step is positive, so we get 3a square plus 2 root 3a plus a square. What you can see, minus and this plus gets cut. 3a plus a square, 4a square, 4 plus 3 7, 7 plus 1 8. So again we got under root 8a square or 2 root 2a. So okay, we have got ab and bc are equal. Now we go for ac. So ac is minus root 3a minus a the whole square plus root 3a minus a the whole square. Okay. What is change? The signs have changed, but let us see what happens next. Though the signs have changed, let us understand what happens next. Minus root 3a the whole square is 3a square minus 2 into, now minus, why minus or plus? You can see this is also negative and this is also negative. So negative to negative becomes positive. So plus 2√3a. 2√3a plus a square. And here we have 3a square. One is positive, one is negative. So minus 2√3a plus a square. Again this and this gets cut. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. Equal to under root 8a square. So 2√2a. So ab, bc, ac. You can see all of these are equal. So the sides are equal. It is an equilateral triangle. Okay. Now the area of an equilateral triangle. Have you revised the formula we had derived? Area of equilateral triangle. Have you derived the formula? Have you remembered the formula we derived? What is it? Root 3 by 4 the side square. This is the formula. So root 3 by 4 side square. What is the side? 2√2a the whole square. So we have root 3 upon 4. How much is this? 2√2 the whole square is 8 into 8 is square. 4 1s are 4 2s are. So final answer is 2√3a square is the area of this triangle. Okay, again we have used distance formula and seen it is an equilateral triangle. We have used the formula for the equilateral triangle, the area, found out the area. But what you can see here again, what I am trying to bring to your notice, this sums are without numbers. They are with variables and variables having positive and negative signs. So you will always use this formula x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1. X2 minus x1, y2 minus y1. The formula is remaining the same. But be very careful with the signs. Learn how to see the signs where you have to put positive, negative. Because here the whole trick relates to the signs. If you get your sign wrong, you may get the wrong answer. Okay, so be very careful and practice this type of sums.
So we have the homework for today now. Find the distance of following set of points. A plus B, B plus C. And A minus B, C minus B. And the second one A0 and 0B. That is quite simple. The second sum is prove that 2A, 4A, 2A, 6A and 2A plus root 3A, 5A are vertices of an equilateral triangle. Finish the homework. Take the screenshot and send it to me. I'm going to end it here. Okay, so I hope this is good practice for you. Do not worry about it, may take some time, may be a lengthy sum, but look at the signs carefully, okay, and use the formulas correctly and you will get the correct answer. So I end here today. Thank you.